Hi and welcome to All Lights Film Magazine. Today we bring you day 9 and 10 of the Sydney Film Festival. Here are some of the movies that will feature in today's episode.
What is the Iron Man of documentaries?
Somewhere between Michael Moore and Sacha Baron Cohen, with a little Daffy Duck thrown in, Morgan Spurlock is an obnoxious and attention-grabbing but undeniably funny and at times likable documentary maker. With the greatest movie ever sold, he has come some way to getting his groove back after his disappointing travelogue, Where in the World is Osama Bin Laden? The key to Spurlock's filmmaking is that it feels hyper-contemporary and of the moment. From stuffing himself with McDonald's to prove it was bad for you to going out on a hunt for possibly the most demolished man in America's history. He may be the idol filmmaker for the Facebook Twitter era. He comes up with gimmicky concepts to lure you in, grabs sound bits from what people say and displays it in huge text at the bottom of the screen, and conducts vox pops with people on the street.
So what I want to do is make a film all about product placement, marketing, and advertising, where the entire film is funded by product placement, marketing, and advertising.
The greatest movie ever sold gets underway, and we see Spurlock calling up all the big companies and getting rejected, as well as finally securing some, including the little-known band Deodorant, a fast food restaurant unfortunately called Sheets, and Pomp, wonderful pomegranate juice, the main sponsor of the film and the reason for this title.
Is there a plot?
Liz, this is the movie right now.
I think the thing to do is go get a client.
Can we please get Mane and Tail to be the sponsor?
What are the words that you would use to describe Ban? Ban is blank.
That's a great question.
You will never put Morgan, your average Joe, on a billboard, ever.
What if we loaded it with nudity?
Yeah, that would help.
We want to sell the above-the-title sponsorship for $1 million.
Is it going to be Palm Wonderful?
So does $1 million come with 100% guarantee?
For me, yes.
We're in.
Out of this film, they come, they transform, corporatize Morgan Spurlock. That's your challenge.
Well, have you got a pair of these? With product placement, what do you think should be done?
There should be some little pop-up that comes on and says, advertise. It could be a scroll at the bottom, it could be a little pop-up, whatever. But the moment people are being advertised to, they should know they're being advertised to.
What you have now is artists partner up with different brands to kind of get that extra push.
Sell, sell, sell.
Presents the greatest movie ever sold.
Where should I be able to go where I don't see one bit of advertising?
To sleep.
The Chinese filmmaker Shen Kaigi's Farewell My Concubine was the first Chinese language film to win the Palm d'Or at the Cannes Film Festival and follows the journey of two peaking opera stars through the Cultural Revolution. In 2008, he directed a new production of Turandot conducted by Subin Mehta. Chen's new film, The Sacrifice, is based on the Chinese opera and opens at the Sydney Film Festival.
Chang Yin, 为救赵家的孩子，牺牲了自己的妻儿，
会吗？
不会吗？
我让他们相亲相爱，然后赵家的孩子一剑砍了屠文武，
做梦。
杀不了他，波儿！
来人！
这就是命。
pass for the Sydney Film Festival, and here are the top 5 movies voted till today. Three Rwandan kids hit the road to soccer's World Cup in this energetic and enjoyable feature. Dudu is convinced that his best friend Fabrice is going to be a football legend. Then a FIFA representative offers Fabrice a chance to audition for the opening celebrations of the 2010 Cup, Dudu, his self-appointed manager, convinces him to make the trip to Rwanda's capital.
Kidding me if Daniel is even thinking about this.
The next time your parents see you, you will be doing your silky skill in front of Mr. and Mrs. Obama. It's not that far.
Don't be crazy, Dudu. South Africa is miles away. It's impossible.
Impossible is nothing. Let's go all the way. The world is our ostrich.
You don't look much of a team.
Give us a chance to prove it.
Hurry up! Hey!
Be careful, Dudu.
10 days till kickoff. We need to move faster.
Get down! The jungle is not big enough to hide you.
We don't have to do this just so I can kick a ball in the air.
It's not about you. It's not about me. It's about us. We're a team. Africa United.
This year, when everyone unites, anything is possible.
Where's the manager?
Africa United.
The dream is over. Wake up.
He's upset. And as a manager, you have to know how to handle that.
Coming soon.
As a vocal advocate for everyone's right to sexual expression, Sydney sex worker Rachel Wharton is passionate about providing people with disabilities the opportunity to experience sexual intimacy. She helped set up an advocacy group, runs workshops for carers and sex workers, and is studying for the master's degree in her spare time. The indefatigable blonde also provides a specialized service to her clients, two of whom, John and Mark, permit the cameras in to record their most intimate moments. Their pride and pleasure makes this one of the most uplifting films you'll see all year.
Mark needed that little bit of help.
Rachel sees them as people, but she sees them as people that want to explore themselves to the fullest.
Yes, you have good muscles.
I would like him to lose his virginity.
Oh, I cannot wait.
It's completely legal for a sex worker to come here. You can order in like a pizza.
People with disability want connection, intimacy and touch.
What am I going to do with you tonight?
People don't want to talk to me about sex. They just want to know where they can get it.
Tonight's really important. I haven't got much movement below the knee. To be able to achieve normal sexual function when you think yourself incapable of it, I feel like a real bloke again.
These are people that very often has, for a long time, never been touched.
Everybody needs to have somebody to hold hands with.
Sexuality and sexual expression is the last bastion.
It has been my dream to have a woman stay in my bed overnight.
Everyone has a right to sexual expression, and that includes people with disability.
Shane Meadows' first foray into television sees a return to the characters of the provocative BAFTA-winning feature film This Is England 2006.
Right, come on, lads, look into the camera and just smile. One sec, there's someone here, let me get the...
Oh, come on.
He's got beer, that's the password.
Oh, sorry, you're right, man. Smile, man, smile. I found the camera. Don't break it, though, because...
How do you like it, you big bellend? Come over here, there's something on your face, come here.
You're going to rip me. I know you're going to rip me.
Go with me.
That lollipop, come here and give me a kiss.
On and things have changed for the motley band of outsiders just as they have in the Thatcher's Britain. The Falklands War and the xenophobia, which cast heavy shadows in the feature film, receded thematically and unemployment has come to the fore. The collective anger has toned down and everyone is just more anxious about making ends meet. Sean has already split from the gang and drops out of school after failing his exams. Combo is all out of jail having done time for his brutal attack on Milky. Woody and Lola are getting hit and Maggie has a heart attack. The only constant is Mel, who retains a striking fashion sensibility and a soft spot for Sean. Kicking off with the warmth and humor that pulls you in for the ride, the four-part series progressively darkens and Meadow's transition to the tube ultimately proves just and uncompromising as a cinema. This is England 88 is currently in the works. Andrea Durbach is Sydney resident since 1989 and currently director of Australian Human Rights Centre, returns to South Africa to meet her clients from the landmark Upington trial. In 1985, when apartheid was at its most violent, a black policeman was burned to death and 25 people were convicted of his murder. 14 were sentenced to hang. The dramatic battle for justice as told by Durbach, independent journalist John Carlin and the accused, and the subsequent truth and reconciliation hearings are both revelatory and inspirational.
That is the truth. You've got to be kidding. You can't have 25 people convicted of the murder of one man. It's, I mean, even in South Africa, that seems ludicrous.
Hey, we've got it already.
The broader political circumstances of South Africa, the specific circumstances on that day, the particular reasons why, unhappily, this man ended up being killed.
They'll do their thing very quietly. By the time the world hears about it, we're already dead by then.
Exactly.
I think that was the grand plan.
This is so huge, this is so impenetrable, this is so already decided what's going to happen.
Saba no rumbuzo smoothba. Kabasi kezangolo trobo o. Sikwa tangolo trobo basi pumengi zing mama no tata. Sekwen zinduen kulukangaka ubula no.
You were found to be there. You have to tell us why you did what you did so that we can use that evidence. You know, you would have to, in a sense, come clean. I don't know you, really.
Oh, my God.
Bro, that's about a meter long. Was brought to me.
There's a lot of apartheid. There's a lot of racism in Upington.
Andy Anton's been shot 9 times.
Chad Morgan has lost count of the number of times he's been reported dead, but the politically incorrect country singer with the donkey grin is much alive. The Sheik of Scrubby Creek is still on the road almost 60 years after kicking off his career on Australia's Amateur Hour. Chad's life is the stuff of legends, his rapid rise to the top, womanizing, heavy drinking, and a story narrated by Tex Perkins is told with just the right mix of rollicking style and the genuine respect. That pretty sums up in today's edition. We'll be back with the winners of the Sydney Film Festival. See you then.